happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up you guys? Craft Farms here, and welcome back to another Thursday modding. Today, I'm finally revealing my project. My secret project. I've let a couple little things slip on accident. If you watched Monday's video, I kind of let it slip where I said something about the corn texture would look good on my new project. And then I had to cover it up with, you know, talking about that I was talking about the 16x map that I'm doing, which that I am doing too. As you can tell from the title, you already know what this is. I have started a new map. I'm just going to say this now. Two things. One, this is going to remain private. I will not be releasing this. Two, this is not replacing my other map, my Will Brothers Farms map. This one is just in addition to that one. Because I wanted one, you know, it's still based on real area, but I don't have to completely follow everything, you know, spot on and be absolutely perfect with everything. So, the map that I'm doing now is based around Lemoore, North Dakota. And I'll show you here the area in Giant's Editor. Lemoore, North Dakota. So my map is based like in this area here. I guess I don't have the thing here anymore. But yeah, so based around this town, I don't have the town included because I'm not going to do a full-blown town. I'm just going to kind of do some random areas. If we look here, here is the thing that I'm going off of. This is mostly flat. It's mainly flat, like, in the middle. But then the edges have some, you know, kind of terrain to them. And then I went in and added the river myself. I just set this to replace. And, set a height and then dropped it down. The river doesn't show that well, you know, unless you're zoomed into it. So, but whatever. I need to get a culvert and put it there eventually as well. But anyway, yeah, so far I've got the highway in. I'm using the roads for my other map. And then I have the river. So now I'm going to work on putting in the gravel road. That river is actually a little bit farther that way than... Or well, actually, let's just look here. See, right here's the river. Okay, so it's actually pretty close. It's just a little bit to the left. So, but yeah, the reason that I'm doing this map is because I wanted one that's not, you know, like I said, it doesn't have to be spot on to any area. You know, like I am doing, you know, like the field layouts will be the same somewhat. You know, the road layouts, the river. You know, some things are going to be the same, but I can do different things. I can put the farms in different positions than they are now. I can, you know, put the farms together how I want. And, you know, also because I can put animals on this map. You know, my other map, there's no animals on there that you can do. Here, I'm going to put beef and pigs on. So then there will be alfalfa on here, you know, all that good stuff. It'll still have all the multi-fruits like the other one. And just, you know, all kinds of different features that aren't, you know, aren't in my other map that I want, but, you know, couldn't add to that one. I mean, if I really, really, really wanted to, I could have and made it, you know, realistic in that aspect. But I don't really want to, so... Decided I'd just start another map. So yeah, I'm just, you know, kind of going with things. You know, like, I'm importing the things as I need them. So if we look here, in the models. You know, I have the roads and then I have the water. That's all that I have right now. So, you know, everything else will get imported as I go. And then the only other thing I've changed is I put in my gravel texture. But at the moment, that's all that I changed. You know, I haven't changed the grass texture yet. You know, I'll do that later on. I haven't changed anything else except, you know, just brought in the roads, brought in the water, and changed the gravel. Otherwise, everything else is the way that it was. This is a 4X map, which means it's basically four Westbridge Hills put together. Anyhow, we're going to go ahead and we're going to get started on this gravel road. We'll start right here. Oh, I'm still selected on grass, so that's not even going to work. I was kind of wondering why there was no gravel showing. So I'm just starting off with a size 2 brush on these, and then probably in this video even, we'll see how far along I get. Okay, I need to sign out of Steam because those are driving me nuts. We'll see how far I get in this video, and then we might go in-game and just, you know, buy a pickup and drive around and take a look at some stuff. I'm not going to have a full-blown town on this map. I'm just going to have kind of like a little corner in the map. Maybe not even that, but like an area where, okay, you know, here's the dealership. Over here is the elevator. Here's your crop production services for seeds and whatnot. You know, and just stuff like that. So that's what I plan on doing there. I'll just get that in. Don't tell me. Oh, I'm still on grass, dang it. I hate when that happens. Okay, let's go back and remove this grass here. We'll go square. Put that to grass. Oops, helps to be in the right mode. Yeah, so, you know, right now this is the Thursday modding video. Next week I might just throw videos of this in, you know, every couple days or whatever. You know, have a couple days where you got double videos or something. Like maybe the middle of the week there'll be videos of it or something. You know, I'll figure that out later. So we'll just get this one gravel road in, and then go in game to try it. I do also want to change the what do you call it? The PDA. There we go. It's like mine was blank there. Okay, and then I'm gonna bring this down a little bit as well. So that it's barely above the ground. That'll give it a better, you know, it'll be a lot closer to what it is then. And you know what? Actually, I could bring this down even farther. You can go like this, maybe. Okay, so then we'll just turn the visibility off on it. And okay, so now we can go back and fix it. Make the adjustments that are needed. So now if we go 2.25 and go back to gravel, then we can select this here. Let's see, I wonder if square would be better for this. Yeah, it is. Okay. So we're going to go back to grass. Back to gravel. So first off, we'll just cover this whole thing in gravel here up top. So once we get around this curve, it'll be pretty, you know, pretty easy then. I'm just going to kind of throw some spots of dirt in there. Make it kind of washy. Or washed out, whatever, I guess. So we still got a little gravel there. Yeah, I hate doing these angled roads like this, because it's just such a pain. Sorry if you guys can hear that. I have zero idea what the crap they're arguing about. And zero care. That's my sister's. Very annoying. So then another thing that I'm going to add to this map is the ditches. This area, I'm pretty sure, would have ditches similar to what it's like in most of the rest of the state. The ditches just kind of go, you know, like a big kind of, you know, almost like the river here, but just not as deep. And then maybe a little bit wider. So, well, something close to that. Okay, so we can go here and then go. So then this road goes straight across, correct? Yep, straight all the way. Okie doke. Now for a nice long road. Nice long gravel road here. And when we get close to the end, we'll save. Just because Giant's Editor likes to freeze when you mess around on the edges. So, which, speaking of the edges, I do need to fix the grass around the edges. When I covered the whole map in grass, I accidentally got just a little bit too small on my brush size. So, there is spots where there's no grass around the edges. So, it's a pretty easy fix. It's just an annoying fix because, like I said, Giant's editor likes to freeze and crash when you're messing around on the edges. So, and I'll actually show you guys here the other map that I'm working on. 16x, single side, single pole. This is based in Plateville, Wisconsin. I'm working on this with another guy. And this is a map that we're working on. He's got a lot of stuff done on it already. If you want to see the progress of this, go check out Canadian Farming and Modding on Facebook. It's a page. It'll be linked down below in the description. I'll be sure to add that there. But yeah, go check it out, and you can see the progress of it on there, and along with all the other cool projects and mods that are on there. Really good group of guys there. And it took ages to do that highway because, as you can see here, it's only 10-meter pieces for a long ways, and then I have a few 50 meters, and then it's back to 10 meters. Then there's the curve, and then back to 10. And the reason I had to do it that way was because of the terrain in that area. That, like over in there, as you can kind of see, you can see it starts straightening out or leveling out over there. But then, like in here, all this was, hilly-ish, I guess I'll say. It's not a full-blown hill, but it's also not flat. So, there's all that area there that you had to work with. It was a lot of move a piece, adjust the terrain on one of the sides, because, one side you could line up with the terrain, and then the other side you had to, use the brush and adjust it manually, and then move on to the next piece. And then after a while, like I would remove the grass ahead of me for a ways, and then, put in the road till I got to, where it's all grass again. Then go and delete the grass a ways, and then do it all over again. It went pretty fast though once I got to where it started leveling out. Then it was just a whole bunch of 50-meter pieces for a while, and then there was like two or three of them where I had to adjust the terrain a little bit on one side, and then I got to where I needed to do the 10-meter pieces again. Did all those, and then I got to the curve, put in the curve, and then continued on and whatnot. And then after the curve, it was kind of flat for a little bit. And then I had to start adjusting again. And actually, by the time I had to start adjusting, I was getting close to the edge. So I just put in all the rest of the pieces, and then I went back, removed all the grass on them, and then I went back and adjusted the terrain height on them. So got it all done finally then, and got the river put in, and I was like, all right, now I'll start recording a video of it. Hey, we got two squares left. So we're getting pretty close to done now with this road anyways. The other road I'm dreading finishing because of that dumb curve. I always hate the curves because like you can never, I don't know, you can't get this stuff to go to like curve very well. I don't know, maybe it's just me, I have no idea. I have trouble with it. That's what I'll say. Because I don't know if other people do or not, but I do. Okay, so we'll get up here close to the edge. There we go. Oops, I kind of got a little bit of gravel there on the side. Okay, so now we'll go to 2.5. Switch to this mode. Yeah, as you can see here, here's a spot where there's no grass. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save before I do this, because if I don't, I'll end up having it crash, and then I'll be screwed. I'll be out a bunch of progress. Well, not really a bunch, I guess, but a fair amount. Okay, so then we'll remove this. We'll get... Well, I'll have to close the... I'll have to close the map here in Giant's Editor. And then reload it so I can get the PDA image. Because as far as I know, saving, closing, and reopening is about the only way to get... You know, like if you paint gravel and stuff... That's about the only way to get that to appear. So, that is what we'll do. I've tried like the reload, all textures, reload textures. Tried all that and never works. So, which I think that's just a change. You know, like if you made changes like what I did, I still had the map open and I just, had put in my gravel texture over top of the existing one, you know, the Giant's texture, and it, you know, of course didn't change right away, but then I clicked reload all textures. I probably just needed to click reload textures, but clicked that, and then it changed it to mine. Holy smokes, we got a ways to go yet. Yeah, removing grass is definitely not one of my favorite things to do, but it definitely beats, you know, like I've known a few people, they put in all of their stuff, like they finish their map and then they go and put the grass in afterwards, and to me that kind of just seems like more of a pain. I don't know, maybe, but I prefer just, you know, you start the map, cover it in grass, and then just delete as you go. But that's just me. Other people prefer to do it the other way, you know, whatever, that's how you do it, I guess, you know. I don't know, I wonder if there'd be like a way to just edit the map 01 file to edit like the grass weight and just do it that way or something, I don't know. Huh. Oh wait, that's not. Oh, that's just that, I don't know. I have no clue. I don't really care, I guess. This works, so I guess I'll just work on it. Yeah, we definitely have a ways to go until we're back to that road. But hey, it's a big map. That's like the 16x map. I couldn't imagine doing the roads for that one. So far, all I've done on that one is the DEM. And then the other guy, he's been working on it. He's been working on the roads. He got a bunch of roads in. And then he's been working on the town, I think. from, you know, the pictures that he sent. And then he did get one beef farm done too. Another thing I plan to add to this map is map buyable objects. So like I'm gonna set up, you know, like you just start on a small grain farm with, you know, like limited capacities. Or, well, actually, I'm going to use the meridian bins. Well, actually, not even the meridians, but you guys kind of get the point. You know, I'm going to use like the grain bins. Basically, the way that I do those is you just put them in here in Giant's Editor, and then, you copy all of like the coordinates, you know, like all of the translate XYZs and the rotate XYZs, and then you just edit your vehicle, your default vehicles XML or your career save game XML, you know, however you want to do it. I've set it up now so that, like, I did an edit to the Duke farming map. I set it up so that way when you start a save game on it, all you start with are those grain bins. And you know, that's just how I set it up. You could set it up like you start the save game and then you just bring them in with your default vehicle or your career save game, or no, with your vehicles XML, that's what it is. But I prefer to just edit this here default vehicles XML file and then just, you know, get rid of whatever small starting equipment it has and just go from there. But like for this map, you know, that I won't edit until later on, of course. You know, like the farms are gonna be the, you know, some of the last things I put in, because you know, here I'll start off doing all these gravel roads, then I'll go ahead and put in the fields, and then you know, put in like the dealership and the sell points. You know, like pastures or whatever, you know, go and set up all the other stuff, and then I'll throw in the farms and whatnot. But anyway, back to the map buyable object stuff. I'm getting way off track. The way I'd set that up, you know, like start on a small grain farm with some small grain bins, and then you can purchase, you know, like I'll have facilities and bins and whatnot set up elsewhere around the map that you can buy. Like the way I'll have those set up is there'll just be like a fence around the area. And then like, you know, you can see the bins and whatnot, and they'll just be sitting in like what'll look like a hay field with like a fence around it, like a metal fence or something like that, or gates or whatever. And then once you buy it, then those gates will disappear. The grass will disappear and the gravel will appear, and then you'll be able to access those grain bins. And then, you know, like the facilities, it'll be like an area of trees, you know, like a clump of trees or something. And then, you know, you'll buy it and those trees will disappear. And I kind of got some of these ideas from the county line map. I really like the way that the map buyable objects is set up on that one. You know, you buy your facilities, you buy sheds, but for me, it'll be you buy other farms, you buy, you know, then you can buy your, you know, extra facilities or extra bins or whatever, you know, whatever it is that you plan to buy. And then, of course, you know, I'll start in, you know, some good equipment. You know, I'll have like some of my mods that I have, and then I'll have those put in. Oh, here we go. Put in, you know, for the starting equipment and whatever. Okay, so now we need to make this round, and we need to go like about like that. Shoot. Wrong mode. There we go. So now we got our turning area. Oops. Huh, this side didn't get as big as the other side though. So we're gonna make that a little bit bigger. That'll work. It's not perfectly even, but it's about as close as I can get it. Suppose if I really, really, really wanted to get it really close, I could, but I'm not that worried about it. It'll do for me. Okay, so let's close and save. And then we'll reopen. We'll close that, close that, close that. We'll go view, PDA. We'll go print screen. And we'll open the PDA map here. Go control V. Then comes the fun part of rescaling everything to fit. Perfect. So we can save and close that. Okay, and then map icon, map preview. I don't know how I want to do that. I'll just grab some Googler screenshots of the place. We'll just throw in a few areas, I think. Okay, I need to search it again. Excuse me, just one second. Okay. And I guess this guy, the thing doesn't want to go that far. I don't know. Whoa! Exit ground level view, please. I don't know what the heck that was about. So I guess we'll just grab like some pictures of the farms or something. I don't know. We'll get the snipping tool. New. So the map icon will be this, I guess. I don't know. Okay, so let's just see, did that copy the right thing? Keep canvas size. I'll just shrink that to fit. So the map icon, the map preview will be this for now. And the sample mod stuff. I mean, these are just temporary things, just so I know that this is, you know, that it's the my map, I guess. Just something so it doesn't have these boring sample mod picture things here. And we'll just get these three opened up. And wait, cancel. Then we want new. And then cancel. And then this. And we'll just grab a screenshot or a snip of this area. Okay, so there's one. Let's get this brought back up. In fact, we'll get positioned first with this. Then we'll go new. Copy. Sample mod 2. Well, I guess image 3. Whatever. So then once the map's done, I'll put, you know, better ones in there. You know, ones that are actually from in-game and whatnot. Save the images. And there we go. Nope, I don't want to save that. Can close that. We can go back to the perspective. Close that. Okay, and then those are PNG images. So that should be about the only errors that I have. I'm pretty sure I edited mod desk. I remember doing it, I think. Yep. Okay. Okay, so evidently OBS does not like when I zip things up. So, what is it? Aha! Eastern Dakota Farms. So, I'm just gonna watch the log thing to see if I have any errors. I know there will be two because of the single sign single pole thing being PNG files. Yeah, PNG raw format. Oh, there's just one. Okay, and then it's loading the i3d file. Yeah, just that one error. Then there was, it must have been a mod error. No and no. Oh, I forgot to change that. The career start point. Okay, so let's just go like that. Bring in some money and buy a pickup. I don't know where it's gonna spawn, but I haven't moved the spawn point yet. We'll go with this guy, I guess. It's one of the faster pickups. Okay, so where are we? Okay. So I'll go ahead and read through this. This is pretty much what it's going to be upon completion as well. Welcome to Eastern North Dakota, near a little town by the name of Lemoore. I have taken the terrain data from Google Earth for the area. Fields are similar to the actual area, and the highway runs the same, but the rest is all stuff I've come up with. Your father is retired from farming and asked you to take over. You will find his trusty old iron equipment in the sheds around the yard, along with a newer auger and bins. Farm the few fields you own and make some money to upgrade to area farms/bin sites and to get more land and bigger equipment. Happy farming and happy ranching. The map features many neat things like opening doors, soil mod, chop straw, damage mod, swathable canola, which I plan to add. I'm going to figure out how. Buyable objects and HD sky textures. It also includes many very nice objects from many mod sites and other maps. All credit goes to the original creators for the objects. I only take credit for any objects I have made and for assembling the map. I've also added additional crops like sunflowers, oats, rice, sorghum, soybeans, and alfalfa. The map also has beef and pigs installed to have the ability to ranch on top of farm. So, yeah, that's about what it is. If we go here, we can take a look at it. Kind of an overview. The water, I don't know what the deal is with that. I might have to figure out why that does that, but I haven't changed the sky textures yet either. That's another thing that I plan to change in the future. So we'll just kind of go over here and we're gonna fast forward time a little bit, which I just wanted to go that off, that off, that off. So mainly I just want to test the gravel, see how that is, and I just kind of want to drive along the road here as well, just kind of see if there's any spots that I notice that I need to fix, the terrain in it or the grass or anything. Everything looks pretty good so far. Pretty awesome. Cool. So what we're going to do is just whip around here and head up north to the gravel and go check that out. I plan to also change things like the sky textures and whatnot, and I'll be getting rid of all these icons except for that one. That's your farm trigger. I remembered how to get rid of all these, but I'd have to look again because I forgot. But I removed them all on my map, so I know I can do it. I just don't remember how exactly. I know it was one of my buddies that told me how. Turn on and bam, that's like the perfect size. Awesome. So then the section lines will be even smaller for any that there are. But yeah, I think that's gonna do it for the video. I am gonna keep working on this. The next video, I don't know what I'll be doing. I don't know when the next video of this will be, anything like that. So, but anyway, let's just fast forward time a little bit here. There we go. Get us some daylight here. Dang, that's a big river. Holy smokes. I made that way too big, I think. I don't know. Let's drive down in it once. Bam. Good thing I don't have damage mod in. Oh, yeah. There went the pickup. Anyway, guys, as I was saying, that'll about do it. I'll be working on a bunch more stuff and whatnot, and then be back again with some updates and whatever. So, yeah, thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Be sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Be sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Excuse me. Oh, I have a dry throat right now. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to all of my social medias, my mod site, my PC specs, my upload schedule, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.